Today I'm going to demonstrate how the new avoidance routing feature in ADS 2019 can be used to easily build DRC-compliant RF module and package layouts. So to do that, I've got a pretty simple four-layer module here with the chip on it, and the top layer is red, the bottom layer is green. And what I want to do, I've got most of the module completed, I want to just connect one last net, which is this bias line, and I want to connect it from the top layer, which is a chip and wire output, over across the board to the bottom layer of the package so that I can connect it into my larger system. But to do that, it's going to be a little bit challenging right now because most of the rest of the geometry is complete. And I'm going to need to kind of weave this trace through all this different geometry and not mess up any of my DRC spacing rules. So let me show you how avoidance routing works. To enable it, I go to Options, Technology, and then Trace Routing Rules, and it's really easy to add the type of minimum spacing rule that you want, even if you don't have a DRC database set up. So you can just say Add Rule, and I've got the first two PC layers connected. Now I'm going to make PC3, and 60 microns is going to be my minimum spacing rule for that layer. So now I have the top three layers set up with minimum spacing rules, and you can also do it for vias as well. So I hit Apply, and I'll say OK, and then I'm going to make a trace. So to make a trace, I will connect, or I'll press the T key, and then I want to have this option enabled, which is avoid obstacles when routing. And I also like to use follow mouse, which makes it a little bit more interactive as I'm moving the mouse around. And I'll start making my trace. And when I've got this feature enabled, you can see that as I move my trace around, I get these little envelopes around the geometry on the same layer, and it keeps it at the DRC minimum spacing. Now, at any point, if I want to anchor my trace, I can just click the button, it will anchor my trace there, and I can move it. So here I'm on the top layer, and I'm kind of getting to the end of where I'm able to go with my geometry, so I'm going to move down at a convenient point to the second layer. And here I can easily weave my way through on the second layer, but even on this layer, you can see it's pretty hard to get over to the pin. So I'll go down to layer 3, and walk the trace around, and finally to layer 4. So there you have it, it's that easy. I've got a DRC compliant trace that I've routed between the top and bottom metal layers on this fairly dense module using avoidance routing. Now there's one other capability I wanted to show you with avoidance routing that I use all the time, and that's how to make an inductor. The first thing I need to do, so I want to make an inductor between these two points here. The problem right now is that they're on different nets, and I want to connect these two nets and make an inductor. So the way avoidance routing works is, of course, you can only connect objects together on the same net. The rule is you avoid all of the nets except the one you're on for avoidance routing. But here, these things aren't in the same net. So let me show you a really easy trick to connect two nets if you're making a trace and you want to, you know, you're being prevented with avoidance routing from making that connection. You just hit the C hotkey, and this will put you in connect mode, and then you select the pin that you want to connect to, and then it'll allow you to merge the nets. So this will let me connect these two nets together, and now I can put an inductor between these two nets, which I need for my matching network. Another feature that's nice when you're making an inductor is this avoid same net feature. That's going to let you make a spiral that's automatically DRC compliant as well. So I'm going to start a spiral inductor now between these nets, and I'm going to click, and then I'm going to hit the N hotkey to put on avoid same net. And this will let me now apply the DRC minimum spacing rule even to objects that are on the same net as I'm already on. So really useful for building inductors. I can go there, kind of drop down a via, and now I'm on metal 2. And you can see how easy it is to just kind of use these rules to spiral around an inductor, because I can keep all of these DRC rules at the minimum. And finally, I'm going to turn off same net avoidance so I can finish completing my trace. And there you have it, an inductor that's designed automatically to be DRC spacing compliant. So if you haven't already, open up ADS 2019 and try out avoidance routing.